What's going on, guys? So today we're just gonna do a quick install video. My brother has a 2018 Toyota 4Runner. I think it's a fifth gen. He got a little Gobi roof rack for it, so we're gonna be throwing that on today. Yeah. So we're gonna be taking off these stock roof racks and putting on a new one. Gotta get all packaged and everything. It's from Gobi, right? Yep. Gobi roof rack. Stealth. The Stealth? Yep. Full length Stealth Gobi roof rack. I need to do something with this one, this old one. I can take a little pry tool. Kind of get it right in between that rubber gasket. And you guys don't want to lever, you just want to pull just straight up on it. There you go. Just like that. And then you're going to have two 12s on each one. Two right here, two over there, and two over there. It's a total of 8. So once you guys get those off, you guys are going to want to clean off all the debris that was sitting under those stock rails. You already got this other side clean, you said?
Yeah.
That's what a clean one should look like. There's just a dirty one. We're over here laying out some parts. Check out these pretty cool little Gobi. What would you call these little tabs, I think? I think that roof rack's gonna sit on.
Brackets.
Yeah, some brackets. Okay, so we're gonna get ready to put on these Gobi brackets here. So it goes like this order right here. So you guys have, it should be all in one bag too. You're gonna find all these seals in your one hardware bag. So it's gonna be a little skinny rubber seal. That's gonna go first, followed by your spacers. Followed by this next rubber seal. This one's different than these guys because this one has a little longer edge, if you see. That longer edge always goes towards the inside of the car. So for example, this side is gonna be pointing towards the inside and the passenger side is gonna be pointed towards the driver's side. And you guys are gonna use this metal, what they call this at? Something. Another metal spacer, I guess. This is what's gonna seat close up. Cover plate, yeah. So this is your cover plate. And followed by another small skinny gasket just like the first one. And then you go over your racks and go straight on top. For the bolts, they give you guys a locking washer. That goes first. And then a flat washer with the rubber side down. So that's after we got them all stacked. It's kind of like a little bit of a balance. You gotta stack and make sure you still have the holes all lined up. As well, let's just get in this. Are you gonna hold this hand? Also, they give you guys a little anti-seize full bolts. I guess we'll throw some on there. So that's gonna be your final result right there. Don't snug these down all the way. Leave a little bit of free play in there for when we put the rack on. But if you see, I don't know if you guys can see on that. That's why we left that rubber seal facing the inside, because it gives you that seal right there. You guys can see that.
It's like the wind picked up a little bit.
All right, so now we got all four corners done. One up there, right there. Remember, leave these loose a little bit. You want a little bit of free play in it when we get this rack on. Getting this thing ready. So yeah, once you guys get these brackets on, it's pretty much just getting your bolts for those brackets set up so you're not having to wait around, and then just putting putting that rack on top and putting those 8 bolts in. This is a pretty hard two-man job to get this rack on top of here, just because the 4Runner's wide, and so we're having to, you know, one of these on the whole way over. I wonder how much that rack weighs, to be honest. Probably, what, 100 pounds?
No, it's like 75.
75 pounds? I don't recommend doing that with two people. Definitely want a third guy in there to do that thing was a bitch. So we got, I think we're gonna start snugging down the bottom bolts first to bring these brackets up so they're not as loose hanging down. And then we'll leave, if you see those bolts that are going to the brackets from the rack, we're gonna leave those loose so we can kind of fine tune the rack and get it perfectly straight. It's already looking pretty straight right now. I think Anthony's working. What are you working on over there?
Right for the front feet on.
Okay, yeah, these things. So these things don't even go in anything. They just sit on top of this rubber seal. And whenever there's weight put on the front, these will come down and meet that rubber seal. And that's where your weight will be at. They also, what? How far do their brackets need to be from?
I believe it's 3¼ inches.
From where? From?
From this plastic piece.
Oh, the
mm-hmm.
The gap on it?
Yep.
Okay, so they expect a gap to be on there, huh?
Yeah. That's how you adjust these ones right here. That's for the gap.
Oh, I see.
Let's hook up these ones first.
I see. All right, so yeah, it calls for a 3/4 gap between your rubber seal and the plate. And that's what those two screws, from what I see back there, are for. You just loosen them up and you can slide these two sleeves up or down. We're getting these top brackets cinched down now. Right here in my pocket. I'm getting everything all cinched up. The feet that they give you for the front calls for a 3 3 3 inches 1/4 gap between the bottom of your rail to your foot. And ours is pretty much almost there. I think we didn't really have to adjust it too much. Be installing the ladder on here now. So what they call for is 3 3/8 inches from that rubber seal over. It doesn't matter which side you put it on. You think you can put it on the passenger side too, right? Yeah. So whatever side you're going on, from the rubber seal over 3 3/8 inches. But you guys have that upper plate measured out 3 3/8 inches from that rubber seal. So put a piece of tape here to measure where it's gonna go back. This is just to hold it in place while we kind of get the ladder center on the back. Oh, it looks kind of center-y. So what we're going to do is just get this ladder centered, and then we'll take everything off, clean it, and then put that adhesive on there. Now that we have the ladder centered how we want. Take some tape, because we're gonna be pulling the ladder off to pull off these adhesives. Take some tape, measure where your the edges are. And on the top as well, measure your edge right here to that bracket. And go ahead and pull off that ladder, and we'll get the adhesive off and we'll stick it on there for good. Got the adhesive off, so get that groove in there.
Like it.
Looks good. Drop it. Some pressure on there for a little bit. So now we're gonna be working on that ledge. What is it called? Or the bracket for the bottom of the ladder. So we'll be going right here between your two pieces of tape. What is that they gave us? Oh, sticker thing. Some,
it's like a little I don't know.
Double sided?
No. It's this little metal strip.
Oh, is it magnetic or what the fuck?
Mm-mm. I don't know if it's just a little filler or...
Interesting. Okay.
Because this will go... Or... I don't know, so we'll check this.
All right, we're gonna rehang this. We're gonna get this bottom seal on to the lift, onto the, whatever you call this thing, your hatch. We're actually gonna, it's almost pretty, you wanna get level right there on the edge of your hatch. You wanna push down on it while I center it, or you want vice versa? You want somebody to pull this down while somebody is pushing your adhesive onto your hatch.
Actually looking pretty good.
We've already got that plate nice and sealed on there. You ready? Sure, we're good with our painter's tape that we had right here. Good. Hold on one second. How you looking on those pieces of tape?
Good.
Okay. Alright, I'm gonna put some pressure down on it. Let me know when we get.
Not quite that even, but we do it like that.
Let me know when you think. I'll put some pressure down on it. Let me know.
Let's do it.
Yeah, looks good. All right, now that we got that ladder on there, we're gonna put in the final bottom bracket on. That's why you put that little metal piece right there, because that's what this is going to be on. You want it down a little bit right there. And if you see, they're going to give you two supply Allens, and that's what's going to go right there in the bottom of your ladder after we get that all mounted up. Just like that. So there's the final product. Tighten up those Allens, tighten up your locking nut to the bottom of your ladder. It's looking pretty good. Don't close all the way, just the stuff in the way right there. Yep, perfect. Okay. We got the top bolts all cinched down. I guess we'll go ahead and see. Yeah, that's pretty sturdy, actually. But jump up and down on it. Feels good. Feels nice. The last thing we have is the wind deflector, right? That's what it's called? The Gobi wind deflector. It's gonna go right on the top of the rack, right in front of the rack over here. Right in this area right there. That's where it's gonna be. Yeah, just getting these flanges already. These are gotta be 3/4 inch from the bend to your wind deflector, and then you'll be ready to go. So, just get all our bolts cinched down on the ladder. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I think all we have left is that little wind deflector that Anthony's working on right now. Let's see. It's pretty straightforward. Just give you these three brackets right here. I think you guys can figure that out. Just keep those three brackets right there. Only thing that you might want somebody to do is push it in so you get that wrap on your wind deflector, so it's just not just a straight block. They also include some tape to put between your rubber seal and your paint. It's like some clear tape. So that's what we're doing here. We're kind of lining out the curve of the wind deflector so we can lay that tape down. I mean, I guess it's up to you if you want to use it or not. I don't really understand the point of it if they have a rubber seal already there. I don't know, whatever. We'll put it on there. Seems looking good though. We're gonna have to roll it out. This thing's looking good now. We'll throw some things up on the top.